Hello everyone, welcome back to NAV Development Training. In this video, I'll show you how you can alter data or insert new record into a table through code. So first, understand what's the purpose of NAV. The purpose of NAV is to help you use business data to improve the way your company operates. That data needs to be saved in the database. So in last videos, I showed you how you can create tables, add key to the table. But in this demo, I will show you how to add, change and remove data or records for the tables in the NAV system. So let's get started. So the another question is how you can do it in NAV. So first I will create a code unit for this and then add a global variable called customer. The type for this will be record, and then I will write the following code. Then I will save the code unit and then test it. So let's see this in action. First, choose the code unit object from here and then click on new. Wait for a few seconds. So this is the cal editor. On run trigger, write your code. Before that, declare a global variable called customer. The data type will be record for that, and then choose your table. So I will choose customer table, click OK. Back to your cal editor, then write the code. Customer dot name. Name is very important for the customer. I'll write the brace Azaz here, semicolon, and then I will insert this record, customer record, into the customer table by using insert, and then I will use the true. This will run the trigger that available on that table. So first I am going to insert a record into the customer table. So when I enter the name over here, so a customer will be created into the system, and I call this statement.
This will insert the record
into the customer table. So after that, I want to get this record by setting the current key. The current key for this will be name, because I am using name over here. Then after that, I will set the range, so this will only choose this particular customer record from the table that I'm currently inserting. Means this will only choose the Braze as customer, and then find the customer first. So whatever the customer will be find first, I will change the name for it. So let's begin the operation. Customer, I will change the name from the brace to other, what is Amit Singh? Amit Singh. And then you must have to use another method called modify to modify the record in the customer table. So I end the operation. So I save the code unit with 50,000, and the name of this add customer. Okay, so it is asking for a variable was expected, for example my var customer name. Okay, I write the wrong syntax over here. I must have to use a field name. So the name is the column name actual. In this, I am looking for the braces as value. So now save the value. So it is saved now. It's time to run this particular code unit. How it actually works? It works like I am creating a customer into the system. The name of the customer is the braces as. Then I insert the value by running the trigger, And then after that, I set the current key for this customer table is name. And after, based on name, I apply for a range value. So it will search only for, look for a customer whose name is Tabriz Azaz. Then after that, if I get the record, then I am using the modify function to modify the customer record. So this is run now. I go back to customer because I hit the control plus R command to run it. If I look for the customer called Amit Singh, no, I did not get the number because I have to filter it with the name. So the Amit Singh is created. Open it. So the customer is created with the name of Amit Singh. This is not actually happened. First, the customer is created for this, the bridge is on. So I am again want to show you how this actually done. So now I am going to look for Amit Singh and then want to move the value. The bridges are hit Control S for saving the code unit, then hit Control plus R to run this code unit. Code unit is run successfully. Go back to customer card, close it, and then refresh this. And if now you search, if you want to search for Amit, then you will not get any record. But if you want to look for Tabriz Azaz, then the same customer number and the name is updated for this. Now the new name is Tabriz Azaz. So this is how you can easily create transaction to alter data. So let's move back to your slideshow. So there is more to know about. There are four type of operation you can perform on record in the database. If you are familiar with the SQL database, you know the CRUD operations. They are insert, modify, delete, and rename. And I also want to give a note over here. Every table has triggers associated with it. They can be viewed by examining the CAL code. When you in the table designer press the F9 button, you will see the several different triggers available on that particular CAL editor called on insert, on modify, on delete. You can just see this by let's see how this looks like. I am go to table, go to customer, open the design view, and you can press F9 or just click on this button. Then you can find over here several triggers. First is on insert, on modify, on delete, on rename. So this is what I am talking about. These are the triggers. You can actually call this code by passing an optional boolean parameter to the command. By default, this code is not called. False is passed. But in the insert command, for our example, I pass true. I hope you understand. There's also some way for catching your errors when you're performing any transaction. So whenever you are using any of the operation like insert, modify, delete, or rename, all returns a boolean value upon completion of the transaction. When the transaction is successful, it returns true. When not, it returns false and display an error message. So it is not always helpful to display an error. Sometimes you might want to continue with that. Whatever you are doing, you can trap the error by using the following syntax. So whenever you are inserting a value to a customer table, if the value is inserted into the customer table successfully, then you can do this, do something after that. Or if the value is modified into the customer table, then you can do something like that. So this is so easy to catch error whenever you are performing a transaction on a particular table. So I hope you enjoyed this video and understand how easy it is to create a transaction to alter a data for a particular table. So in next video, I'm gonna show you how you can validate data into a table. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.